Atelasiano Siata has been living along the River Kafo banks for decades. On the wetlands, she has gardens from which she manages to put food on the table. But the cost of this human activity contributes to the impacts of climate change and extreme weather patterns. An example is the floods being experienced. The National Environmental Management Authority is fighting to protect such ecosystems, and in gazetted areas like this, people must live. Our beans and other property we had were taken by the water, and if we can get help, I'll be grateful. We planted our crops hoping to get the best out of them, but they were destroyed by the flooding, and we are currently depending on Good Samaritans for survival. The River Kafo wetland encroachers have been told to vacate the constructed buffer zone by Tuesday next week. According to security, this has been done to avoid casualties in case the same incident happens again.
I sympathize with them. We have given them a short term. We are coming up with the medium term and then the long term. The short term is for them to get out of food shortage.
So the critical cardinal things that define a wetland are water, whether temporary or permanent, unique vegetation, and the unique animals, but with sandy clay soils.
According to Emmy Ngabirano, the Masindi resident district commissioner, people have tampered with River Kafo wetland, mostly in the districts of Hoima, Chankwanzi and Masindi, hence causing the flooding. He adds that the affected have been given fast-growing seeds like beans and maize as part of relief.
Some of the affected people were the beneficiary of PDM, and we are pushed a report to PDM Secretariat for reconsideration, special extension of their own or further support. We are coming up with restoration of the wetlands, all wetlands in Masindi, which is my area of duty.
We are here to support and develop and live along with the community. That is our aim.
All this that we have received from Kinyara and the rest, we shall compile this information and also send the feedback to our superiors, Office of the Prime Minister, because we had written to them before, indicating the disaster in this area. So
the RDC has advised landlords who are hiring people to cultivate the wetland to stop immediately in order to enable its restoration.
To the landlords that are hiring out land in the wetland, first leave this land for the time being to regain its vegetation, and we also apply land usage. We can have this land for animal grazing, but not again tamper with the already fragile soils.
Bright Mugume, the Chimengo sub-county LC3 chairperson, revealed that since the floods occurred, the affected residents have been pitching at Chimengo Trading Center, and diseases resulting from poor hygiene have so far increased.
Like the bilharzia, diarrhea, malaria has increased up, and we don't have medication at the health center. So our dear members, the government and all the workers who are listening to us, we urge you, we call upon you to come and to help us on adding on the medicine or medicine on the health center.
Last month, River Kafo flooded and swept about 5 square miles of gardens with plants like maize, tomatoes, beans, groundnuts and people's homes in Chimengo sub-county, leaving over 1,500 people homeless. Report compiled by Godfrey Mhumuza for the news.